I can fit in anywhere.
Yeah, you sure can. Come a, come a, come a, come a, come a chameleon. Ralph comes and goes. He comes and goes. Come a, come a, come a, come a.
Love will be easy if your colors are like my dream. Red, gold, and green. Red, gold, and green.
What? So you and Ralph are both. Narf would respect the hell out of these shoes, dude.
Alright. A little tight, but we just gotta break them in a little bit, but...
Yeah, man, they're like... I'm out here. Is that true? Oh, can't see. Rule number one. Don't walk on the carpet in Ralph's house with the shoes on. Ralphie?
Yeah?
How we doing?
How's your horse
doing? You see these things? These horses are ready to fly.
Those are what, the international canoe shoes?
Yeah, exactly. These are the international exploration shoes. I don't know how you don't do enough exploring. All you explore is the couch.
I hit the elements barefoot.
Basically, just, you know, like a residential house with a super sick garden in the back. He bought a little bit of land in his backyard and put a couple greenhouses and produces a lot of fire vegetables. Every Saturday they have a farmer's market in Renzi where he sets up shop and pumps carrots. I mean, you name it, bok choy, whatever.
Can't see. You grew up with this guy?
Yeah, McKeesport High School resident, his wife.
He lives in the high school?
No.
Okay.
Graduate, I should say. His wife, Megan, Fawcett Plan native. Shout out FP.
Shout out FP. Am I gonna get beat up for saying that?
Nah, maybe if you went and jumped in.
Yeah.
I may or may not have told him we were coming up to do work.
What? Pardon?
Balcony in our apartment, and we're like trying to grow corn and shit.
Right, yeah, yeah, going you know, all like, out. We were right, yeah, 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 yeah.
So, you know, we joke around like every single year since then, we've doubled our garden space.
It started as a hobby,
yeah,
and then it went to more like, I don't even know, way more than that. This is my full time.
Awesome.
This
great.
And the kids
yeah.
right now.
Yeah.
I've probably been on this farm today like 10 times
great.
Since this morning.
Yeah. Like I said, the property is 20 acres, but we're growing on a little less than 1 acre.
Right here. Okay.
Yeah, and we all do, right. well, in our name, right, CCR Gardens. So we have different areas. We have our garden up at the house.
Sure.
Yeah. That we're doing mostly like cut flowers and stuff like that in there now.
Awesome.
And then this is our main plot that we're in with the, we got the tunnels and, you know, a lot of the infrastructure, the water irrigation and stuff. And then we have another field way up the hill.
Yeah, show us what's going on.
We're just picking some strawberries. You guys want to try some strawberries?
I'd love to, absolutely. Oh man, look at this.
Look at
this. This is amazing. Look at this. Oh, he doesn't even chew. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You should know by now. Like,
they're not
such
like
a
what
difference.
You get in the store.
Such no. a difference.
So no. the varieties you buy in the store are actually different than these. These ones, like these will not hold up forever. Like probably half of those we're gonna end up eating before Saturday's market
because
they
right
yeah. okay
we'll
yeah
freeze them and reuse them because they don't last that long because they're so much sugar they're so fresh.
You can definitely tell the, mm-hmm. the sweetness.
Yeah,
in
the stuff you buy in the stores are like they pick them and they're like white basically.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
And then they ripen.
Kind of like a banana. They're like supposed to sit on your shelf.
Yeah. So that's one of the main things that we do.
Okay.
Is CSA. It's community supported agriculture, and that's kind of the veggie box. Idea. So,
right. Okay.
The traditional way of doing it is the customers buy in at the beginning of the year.
Right.
So they buy the full season's worth, and then the farmer shares. They call them shares.
Okay.
Every week, whatever's in season, they, you know, we split it up and divvy it out to the people, and you get what you get.
No, it's like 3 weeks ago, and it was radishes and a lot of kale and
right up your alley.
Kale.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Reminds me of International
you
Village
don't
grass.
You don't juice them?
That's what I did. I started juicing again, and now
I think
like,
I just saw him throw a pound in a blender before we left.
make it so we have spinach as much as we can because we know Ralph shows up.
Every week. Right.
I love when the kids go outside or we're down here and they just start eating and it's
can't worry about it, right?
It's amazing.
Yeah, that's our rule. Like, you know, they're always like, we don't want to pick them because you guys are going to take them to market. The kids' rule is anything they can pick, they can eat.
Love that.
No matter what. Don't tell Ralph that.
Dirt don't hurt.
No.
Not our
dirt. I don't wash a vegetable ever. Yeah, I'm not washing these. Dirt. I know there's no pesticides.
Nope.
On.
Yeah. Oh man.
I think
if I catch a slug, you know, yeah, like, right. like a potato bug we or something, slugs. That's just
yeah. Yeah.
That's
extra
right.
protein. Protein for him.
He needs it. Extra. Yeah.
A little extra protein.
Way better when it comes straight out of the earth. We should have charged extra for that because there's no pesticides.
Exactly, right. Clearly, you know, yeah, it proves in the pudding.
A lot of the stuff loses so much nutrients. Like carrots lose like 50% of its nutrients after 3 or 4 days.
Really?
Yeah.
And I'm just, wow. I don't know the numbers with spinach and stuff like that, but it's the same thing. I mean, as soon as you pick it, it's dead.
CSA members that'll see you on Saturday, like when that spinach that they'll get, if they get spinach, that would be hucked like the day before.
We pick all the greens Friday before Saturday, before the Saturday.
Awesome.
Yeah, whether it's storming, raining. We've been down here in full rain gear harvesting like all the greens.
I only ever eat like the first 3 inches of the asparagus. I never eat the bottom.
Oh, see, I'm gonna eat the whole thing.
Started at the bottom.
I like to be different. How do these pop up?
They might not be ready. These are some of our last ones. Oh yeah, they're not. Oh shoot, they are
good. They're like
dirt on them.
Well, that's what we were thinking. If for a funny reel,
God made
like
dirt
for,
and dirt they'll try it.
Like if we just like had the camera.
These are like sweet.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God. No, it's amazing.
A couple of our neighbors up on the hill, they'll see us in the fall and they'll be like, "Hello, farmers." And we're like, ah! So like all of our tomatoes. This is squash, cucumbers, beans. We have bok choy interplanted with squash here. The ground.
And again, engineering timer. That's got to be all.
Yeah,
timer not yet.
There's the timer in. to make a point with that, like they always say like the farmer's best fertilizers is his footsteps.
I was just gonna say that.
And that means like if you got a timer on your water, yeah, that's cool. You could just set it and forget it and forget about it. But you're not down there to see, oh, these cucumbers got the cucumber beetles on them, we gotta do something.
Exactly.
Or like
that's what I
know we say we don't spray. We do spray. We don't throw any chemicals. That's actually a clay, and that keeps the cucumber beetles away. They get freaked out by it.
Yeah, it's like a mud mask.
Yeah, it's like a mud mask. That's literally what it is.
Okay.
You know what? Fall is like the best time.
Yeah.
Really?
Fall was the best time to grow veggies. Like,
interesting.
Everyone that has a garden, they start it in May, and then by
rip
August,
it up in August,
September,
yeah,
they're ripping it up because they got too many weeds and all that.
Have
you ever had kohlrabi?
No, no. I've never heard of it, to be honest.
It's like our parents kind of vegetable.
Okay.
Like my dad and like a lot of like our parents age customers, that's what they were growing,
just like a root vegetable.
Yeah.
So they look crazy, right? I mean,
wow.
They look like a
like a tomato,
like an alien something, you know. And they're like cabbage flavor.
Okay.
You can just chop them up and put them in coleslaw, or you just put salt and pepper on them. They're good, man. I'm not gonna tell you to take a bite out of them.
No, take it out.
Take a smell out of it.
Yeah, you can tell Ralph to do that. Yeah,
I'll smell it. I don't know about bite.
I mean, Ralph, like you said, I mean, it's just amazing that something like this is right around here.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Well, believable because it's here.
And you can see, I still got some of the onions are still growing in the ground. There's a few that have started to be good.
So we started pulling some of these ones, and
you
just lay them on the ground and let them cure. Yeah, so it was onions, and then we came in, and in between the onions, we planted kale. So this is your kale, this bed here. You got dill as well. Over there, you got parsley and cilantro.
Yeah,
parsley and cilantro.
Carter, don't go through.
And then we're like, well, this tunnel's supposed to get the tomatoes. What the heck are we gonna do? Like, all this stuff was banging.
Right.
So we're like, what, you know, how are we gonna move tomatoes somewhere else? And we're like, let's just
throw it around.
Let's get in there and just plant the tomato plants. You know, most people have like tomato cages, or you know, they'll build like they'll build like a trellis or something. We string them up, these strings, and then once they get up to the top, you let out the string and you let out some more, and then you let the plant lower down. So the plant's all the way up here. Well, now it's down here, so you got another two feet to grow.
Yeah.
We've had tomatoes. We measured them at the end of the year. They've been 20, 30 feet. So we do shiitake. We do shiitake mushrooms. Those you have to inoculate white oak logs for that.
Yeah.
And then we do wine cap mushrooms too. I think you probably had those.
Those
grow on wood chips.
Huh? Yeah, we did.
That's not way too long.
Okay. All right, I was gonna say, what's the number one bone to pick?
Like 6 inches. Like you should know what that is.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Don't let the kids watch. That's right up our alley.
No, you look hideous on here, but it's recording.
What? That's offensive? Oh, is that offensive?